So now we can move on to building the actual LFS system itself. So enter the truth, and this is the environment we'll be building in the final system. Thing I should do is add in make files to that true command. So let me come out and add that here, make files equals minus J2. So I don't have to type in make minus J2 each time. And I'll just check that's there. There it is. So that's okay. So CD back to sources and Linux had just expanded. No, I hadn't. Oh, because I haven't changed into sources. No. Build. Barra, please install virtual env, otherwise build won't work. That's interesting. So it looks like it's trying to build. Oh, so make. Oh, I am confused. The Sphinx build command's not found. Oh, well, I don't know why that's come up on something it should be cleaning. Okay, well, let's see if anything else weird happens. Alright, well, that was a strange error. I've seen that before. I'm surprised it's complaining about a file when it's trying to delete things. Right, so first we've got a patch. find a link and change some things depending on what architecture we're on. So you can see it did 64-bit stuff, so that's okay. Okay, we'll do the build. So this takes 21 SBUs. I presume it's going to include the check. So let's see. Right, so that testing's finished. There's actually two fails there, which is interesting because I only got one when I was testing this. So the easy one is that test TTY name. I got that, and that's already addressed in the book. Unexpected pass. Oh, this one here, test CPU timer, which is an interesting one because I've never seen that before. Now, this is an older machine, so it could be some timeout problem. And another issue I thought of with the seg fault may be an issue with the fact that this is a kernel version 3 running, and that is obviously quite old, especially as we're building for a target of 4. So that may be something not to worry too much about. But I think this particular one here, like I say, is probably to do with the CPU being a slow one. I might have just been lucky when I tested this and it didn't come up, and just unlucky now. So I'll carry on. There's nothing that looks worrying at the moment, especially when I consider that seg fault may be, like I say, an issue with the kernel. So I'm just adding my own country code in here that I wish to use. So just checking to make sure that the tool chain is still working correctly. So parts with half components, Linux GNU should be ignored. So it's this top one and this bottom one. So user lib and lib, that's correct. That's okay. And that's okay as well. Right, I've got some errors. Let's have a quick look back. So one unexpected failure. All right, okay, so this is strange. This is slightly different to what I got. Relative offset overflow check. Not sure what that is. I did get one error with bin utils, but it certainly wasn't that one. Three tests passed. There's one failure here. Okay, yeah, this is the error I had before. So PL177.04A, yeah. So that lines up with what I've got before, unless I hadn't noticed this one, possibly. Yeah, it's quite possible I've not noticed this one. So that's reasonably similar, I guess. So I'm going to carry on building. Obviously, if something catastrophic happens, and I know these tests have failed in a bad way. Notice that's picked out the ABI 64 bits, so that's a good start. Right, so let's check this. Normally GMP builds quite well, and yes, it has. Okay, so that has passed the looks of it. Yep, 180 passes out of 180 tests, so that's good. Install and documentation. Okay, so that's all passed as well. That's good. Even though it's not a recommended test, I always do it because it's part of GCC effectively.